Hey everyone, my name is Kajal and welcome to my channel. In today's video, we'll learn about using Webots and ROS2 together using the Webots ROS2 epuck package. We'll get familiar with different components of ROS2 and how to use them to interact with epuck in the Webots simulation. So without further ado, let's get into it. This tutorial assumes you have Webots ROS2 and Webots ROS2 package installed. If you don't have it, please watch the previous tutorial. I'll add the link in the card on the top right corner and in the description below. With that, let's start by opening a new terminal using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl, Alt and T. Next, we'll launch the Webots ROS2 epuck example. To do this, type the following command: ROS2 launch Webots ROS2 epuck robot_launch.py. You can also use tab to autocomplete the command for you. Give it a few minutes and you should see a Webots window open up with a rectangular arena. You'll also find our robot epuck and a few objects. Let's take a look at our scene tree. If you don't see it, click on the menu bar at top, Tools, Scene Tree. Now in this Webots scene tree, you'll see multiple items. They're called nodes. They are Webot nodes and not ROS2 nodes. To avoid confusion, I'll call them items or Webots nodes. Now if you click on the epuck on this scene tree, you'll see an option for controller and it'll say extern. This means that the Webots controller is being run from outside of Webots simulation. In this case, it is being run by a ROS2 node. So now let's talk about ROS2 nodes. It is one of the core concepts of ROS2. It creates a graph of nodes where each nodes perform a specific task and they communicate with one another using topics, services, and actions. So let's start by looking at the ROS2 nodes for our current example. For this, we'll go back to our terminal. I'm using the keyboard shortcut Alt and Tab to move between applications. Now let's open a new tab using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl Shift T and type the following command: ROS2 node list. You should see two nodes, epuck driver and robot state publisher. Now we can find out more about these nodes using the info command. Now I don't want you to remember commands, so here's how you can look for commands. Type the following in your terminal: ROS2 node --help. With help, you can find out different options and how to use them. Let's use the info option to get information about our nodes. Type the following: ROS2 node info epuck driver. You should see a list of subscribers and publishers. As I mentioned before, nodes in ROS2 communicate with topics, services, and actions. Communication over topics happen with one or more nodes publishing a message and one or more nodes subscribing to the same topic to receive this message. Now to get a list of the topics, we'll use this following command: ROS2 topic list. You should see a huge list of topics, including command velocity and different LEDs. Essentially, they are all topics that you can publish or subscribe to. Let's take the example of command velocity. If you scroll up, you should see the topic command velocity under subscribers for epuck driver. And this is how the epuck in our Webots world will move. When we send a message to the topic command velocity, the node epuck driver, which is subscribed to it, will receive this message and accordingly move the epuck in our Webots world. Thus, if we want to move the epuck, we have to send or publish a message to the topic command velocity. Now to do this, we first need to know more about the topic itself. As before, you can use help to find out all the commands associated with topic. Type the following: ROS2 topic --help. You can see the option info as before to get information about the topic. There's also an option to publish a message using pub. Let's find out more information about the topic command velocity. Type the following in your terminal: ROS2 topic info command velocity. Remember that you can always use tab to autocomplete the command for you. We see the type of message, which is geometry twist in this case. Next, we see 0 publishers and 1 subscriber. In other words, no one is publishing a message to the topic, and hence our robot, which is epuck, is not moving in the WeBots world. So let's publish a message to the ROS2 topic command velocity and move epuck in the WeBots world. Once again, let's use help and understand how to use this command. Type the following in your terminal: ROS2 topic pub dash dash help. As you can see, we need 3 positional arguments: topic name, message type, and values in YAML format. We already have the topic name and message type. The last piece of information we need before we can publish our message is the contents of our message. For this, we'll use the interface command. As before, you can use help to know more about it. So type the following in your terminal: ROS2 interface dash dash help. As you can see, we have the show option to show the interface definition, which in this case is a message. Now, if you don't remember the message type, you can again type ROS2 topic info command velocity. I'm using Ctrl Shift C to copy the message type. Next, type the following: ROS2 interface show and the message type. I'm using Ctrl Shift V to paste the message type. With the interface command, we now know that it expects 2 3D vectors for linear and angular velocity. So now let's try and do that. Once again, if you don't remember, you can type ROS2 topic pub dash dash help to get the information required to use this command. Here's how the command goes: ROS2 topic pub command velocity message type and the message. Now there are 2 ways you can send this message. You can send either the entire message or just the component you want. I've included both of them on the screen here. And remember, the message needs to be in YAML format. With that, let's hit enter. And we can see that the epuck in our WeBots world is moving. You can use Ctrl C to stop publishing the message. And as you can see, it will still continue to drive the robot. The problem being, the way epuck controller is set up, once it receives a velocity, it will continue to drive in that velocity. So to stop our robot, we need to send x is equal to 0 as our linear velocity. Here's another interesting thing you can do. If you open a new terminal using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl Shift T and look at our topic information again using the command ROS2 topic info command velocity, you'll now see it has 1 publisher and 1 subscriber. Another thing you can do is listen to this message using the command echo. So type the following: ROS2 topic echo command velocity. You should now see a string of messages being published. If you go back to the previous terminal and use Ctrl C to stop publishing the message and look at our echo again, we should not see any more messages. Because we stopped publishing, there are no messages to listen to. Echo is essentially a way for you to listen to these messages while they are being published. As you can see, it's pretty cumbersome to send commands via terminal. Generally, you would write a code to do this. You use the terminal when you want to debug or get an understanding of different components, as we did with this tutorial. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and drop a comment below. This will encourage me to make more such videos. Also, if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.